Hello everybody and welcome to today's video where we are playing Shellshock. This is going to be a point battle and then the next game is going to be a team deathmatch. As always, I hope you enjoy the video and I'll catch you in the next one. I never know where to put myself at the beginning. And I'm not going to get a shot doing this. Oh, and I've missed. So that's not a good start. Luckily my teammate did get a score there, so we did get 60. Which you can see up in the top right. And obviously their score is up in the top left, just so I don't have to keep saying the scores. And that was a complete miss from them. So this is where we need to stick it to them. I didn't have a shot. And I haven't got one. At least I know for my next shot that I just need to take a little bit off. And they haven't got much again there at all. So I think I'm just going to aim my shot up a little bit more. And that should change the trajectory. Okay, I don't know why I tried to say that. But I did get a hit, and we are miles ahead at this point. However, we were quite far ahead in the last game. If you haven't seen it, go check that out. But in the long run, we didn't win that one. And we was quite far ahead at one point. So as it stands, we are 100 ahead. But my shot straight into the wall there ain't gonna do us any favours. And he's got really unlucky as he got it straight on him, but it was a one bounce. So this time we don't have any protection, so let's see what happens here. And I think that's 20 points for them. But we still are quite a nice points difference ahead. And I have been rather lucky with that shot. By the way, it has added to the score. And that's a really good shot by them, and that's got them straight back in it pretty much. I'm going to have to back up a little bit. I'm going to try the Glock. And I've got a feeling it's more of a close range weapon, as it's not done much. He got 14, which is not much either. We're going to be in serious trouble here if he gets the double damage. Which he has done, straight onto him and then me, I think. And that's put them quite far in front, which is not good. So I'm going to try a Python. And that's just glanced him and gone the wrong way. That's typical luck. And I'm starting to run out of weapons here. So, well, good weapons at least. We are taking a bit of a pounding now. They've gone 100 ahead. I can't believe this game's turned out like this. I think we've got about 2 turns left. So we seriously need to get some points on the board. And it did appear on that last shot that I had hit him a few times. But we didn't get any points. And they are quite far ahead now, so I think I'm just going to go for a trick shot and call this one a bad do, and it didn't work out. So then the last few turns, and I don't really have much to hit them with. But we're gonna go for the bolt, which is quite a hard weapon to use because, as you'll see, when it lands, it can bounce quite a bit. And it's wherever the bolt lands that is perfect. But I still don't think it's gonna be enough. And it's not. So they have already won. And after this shot, I imagine it's gonna be a little bit embarrassing, as they got 200 off a snipe shot there. Yeah, I think we lost quite badly there. As always, my weapons will level up, but not much, because I didn't really do much. So we've decided to have a rematch, but this time we are playing deathmatch. And we're going first, so let's see if we can get a good shot through the double damage. And that wasn't perfect, but 40 damage, I can't really complain. And they've missed on their first shot. So as long as we can keep complacent and keep hitting our shots, we've got a good chance of winning this. The guy on my team went for an earthquake. So he did get 10 damage to each of them, and as you see, the level leveled out a little bit. And that's a hit, but it could have been a lot worse if I'd have got buried down there. It would be good to point out at this point that we are just playing whatever weapon you're given with, you have to use. So there I had an earthquake, so I just took 10 off each of them, and again the leveling of the map happens. So I'd say we're fairly even at this point. Like I say, as long as we can keep it going and hit our shots, as the other guy on my team misses. And a little 23 damage there, that'll help. I have also got a good line now as well. So I've got the sniper. It's really small bullet. But if I can get it on him, I will get big damage. And there's 100. And he were lucky not to die there. We've definitely got a good chance of winning this now. And they got one damage that turn. So I think if we can kill this guy off at the back first, and then we can double team G Prime. And there we go, that's a kill with the rainbow. And he got a good 40 damage on G Prime. And he's missed his shot altogether. So I hate to jinx it, but surely this one's in the bag. Although even if I hit this, I'm not likely to do much damage with it. Yeah, as I thought, small amount of damage, but every bit counts. And that's another miss from him. Think he was trying to clip the double damage. And I think I am going to struggle to hit him here, so I'm just going to pick up this health. I'm not really sure what the purpose of that was. Either way, we do have three weapons to choose from now that I picked up in that crate. So we're gonna try out the double ram squad. And I've got a feeling I just wasted a rather good weapon there. I think he'd have been dead if that had landed on him. So here we go then, can I hit him with my custom sparkle? And just about, but little damage. That was a really good shot, but he got a little bit unlucky. Whoops! That may have hit him if I hadn't have hit the portal. And then I did nearly hit my own guy. I really like the pixel shot, I think it's one of the best weapons. However, the helicopter strike's really good as well. If I can manage to land it on him. Is this going to be game over? And it is. So we may have lost in the points battle, but we did win the war. I hope you've enjoyed the video, and don't forget to subscribe for more.